child's behavior. Because all higher mental functions are coming from social world, but not from biological nature. They are not biological. They are social by their nature, by their sources. And therefore, there are these two lines of development, biological line and cultural line, which of course is direct and kind of nexus, but they are different because there are these two functions, higher and lower, they have different nature, different source, different origins. So, and that is why Vygotsky introduced the concept of higher mental function. This concept shows the source of development, of human development. Yeah?
Say it again.
This concept within the theory, works so that it really shows the source of development of human beings, which is outside the body, which is outside in the biological things. Remember, Lurie said that if you want to understand consciousness, you have to jump outside the body. The sources are not in your body, it does. And this is the role of the concept. And the second, do you remember, but he discovers the qualitative reorganization. Look, higher mental functions are not built on the top of elementary processes like some kind of second story, yeah? And you can find a lot of stories about this in modern books. Okay? But they are new psychological systems comprising a complex nexus of elementary functions that, as a part of a new system, begin themselves to act in accordance with the new laws. What are keywords here? New system, new laws. So the total reorganization of the whole psychological functions according to the new laws, which are not biological laws, but cultural and historical laws, social. And that's why we must distinguish these two functions, low and high, just to show that when higher functions appear, they reorganize those elementary functions and they are working inside this new system according to new laws and principles. So, and this then are irreducible back for the elementary level. This is the main direction of development. New mental function reorganizes the old ones, creating a new system working according to new laws. And what is this new system, new laws? This is the qualitative change. Yeah? It's not a Lego. So it's something like, well, the organism.
But you can't go look at the old system.
Yeah, of course. This is important. You cannot make a step back because, well, it's impossible. Well, the second concept I would like to present, which is interconnected with the first one, is the concept, and one of the most difficult to understand is the interaction between ideal and real forms. This brings a lot of problems for understanding. The social environment is the source of the appearance of all specific human properties of the personality gradually acquired. I repeat again the same quotation, but I put the rest. The source of social development of child, which is conducted in the process of actual interaction of ideal and present forms. This sounds very unusual for traditional and classical approaches. What it does mean, ideal form, present form or real form? What is this stuff about? But well, actually, this is nothing so difficult to understand. This is the explanation. When I even read, and for those who are lazy to read these old large texts, the example is that when the newborn child, the child cannot speak, he has no developed speech, only mimics and something like that. But from the very beginning, the mother or the father speaks to him as a human being, as if he or she understands the speech. Of course, they are simplifying their speech, but they use grammatically correct constructions. And it means that from the very beginning, the child can perceive somehow the developed form. And because he says that this is very interesting, because something which might appear only at the end of the development is given to the child from the very beginning as something which is already exists and interacts actively and creates the tension, the contradiction which really moves the development of the child. And this is very important. This is interaction of ideal and real form. Well, in fact, any cultural form of behavior we show to the kid is the ideal form. But if we imagine that the child is alone or just communicating somehow with the other kids on the same level, the child will be never able to speak. How is it possible that the child will speak English or Russian? So the child definitely needs mother who speaks to him, or father, who speaks to him from the very beginning, and then gradually the child then imitates the sounds and then tries to follow that. And from the very beginning up to the very end, this interaction between the ideal form, developed form, and the real form. So it goes. They interact all the time. And this is the the main peculiarity, the main specific feature of human development compared to other types of development. In all other types of development, like biological development, you never see that the form which should be appeared somehow in the future, they are now, this form presents now an indirect actively.
Well, let me
give you
some examples.
I gave an example about
other types of development.
Huh?
Other types of development.
Because he said that if you look on, for example, if you look on biology, in biology there's also a development, changes of it. So if you see on the tree, so the tree just grows and changes. So the tree, then the leaves, then the buds, then the flowers, and then the fruits, and that's it. So there's no, at the same time, the fruits. And the roots, which are interacting directly, right?
Or the tree next to it is.
Oh, yeah.
So when Vygotsky was putting together his original framework, what it was that sparked his first thinking? And the reason I'm asking is because it seems like child language acquisition would be the obvious starting point. Because we all see this incredible development.
Yeah.
You're right, but
it needs special time. I'm afraid but maybe we can come to this later if you get time. But anyway, my task is now is to show that every concept works, plays a certain role, and this concept of the ideal and real form really explains the moving force of the world. And it explains the direction. Because if the ideal form is here, you know that development will be aimed to this real, this ideal form. And it depends on which ideal form you will give to the child. So the results will be this ideal form. If this is non-cultural form, so it will be non-cultural child then. So we can then see the direction, the possible direction I mean direction. The word is direction. Okay? Is it okay?
Yeah.
Any speech you will tell me.
Yes, it's
okay. And then I come to the third concept number three, which is mediation. As when we speak about Freud, he did or he, so blah blah blah. So when we speak about the concept, mediation. Everybody loves like a label, like a brand, because it's mediation. People are using a lot of, and as discussing different types of mediation, as you probably know, and helping. So visual mediation and visual mediation, direct and indirect, and then kind of all internal, external artifacts, tools, tools of mind, and if you look on it, just put Google because mediation and you see hundreds, hundreds of sources. But my task is very, very narrow, very simple, and very modest, just to show the place of the mediation. To relation to development, because my task was to show the relation of everyone to development. You know, I am just, you know, speaking on development all the time, crazy boy. Well, this is the basic model of development everybody knows. Yeah, reproduced 1 million times in different papers. That there's a sudden new link, artificially created link between the stimulus and response, which is the sign or the tool, and so on. Well, I don't want to comment this. Even I don't want to tell you the story about the good dandan who died because of it had no possibility to find the stimulus. This is a famous example of Vygotsky. I'm not going to tell you that because he said that in this case the human being is just passing blood and using some artificial sign, because we know all of this stuff, and well, no sense to repeat this stuff again. I'd rather just look at the different angle. From developmental perspective. So, mediation from the developmental perspective. If you look on mediation from developmental perspective, we see at least three points which are very important. And these three points completely explain why Vygotsky was so eager to study and investigate different types of mediation. Why mediation was important for him. For him, mediation was important as a tool to analyze the process of developing, nothing else. Not just for fun, not just to be separate from the others. You didn't discover mediation, I will discover it. No, of course not. So, the first point is that the idea of two streams of development. The second is that mediating activity and mediated activity, what is the difference? And the third point is that products versus process. So, I can skip it because I think you know about all this is in a paper? No idea. Oh, so I was the right place then. I can't make it. First point, two streams. What did he say? He said that there are two types of tools. First is the tools of labor. And the second is the science of culture. But before separation, what is important? Here, I took it from the history of development of 500 functions. Because he says that the whole process, look again, development of environmental functions encompasses two main streams. And one of those streams is the mastering of the external materials. Never mind tools of labor, science, whatsoever, mathematics, drawings, and blah blah blah. Look. And the second stream of development is just organical growth of some environmental functions. These are two streams. And this is very important. Because why it's so important? Because if you take on one stream and neglect the second one, you will not have a complete picture of the whole process. So if you do your research mastery, please don't forget that there are the second one more, which cannot be separated from the first, Of course, we can separate for the sake of research, but then we have to consult how to combine them back. So, mastery of sign is only one of two streams of development of higher mental function. This is the message. Not the only one. As a lot of people say that, because he says that development goes through mastering of signs, artifacts, and blah blah blah. I say I completely agree, but there's only one stream, and there is a second one, which should not be neglected. Second point. Again, from Vygotsky. In his book, he says, mediating activity. It's again the history of development of environmental functions. It's very, very common. Almost everybody knows about it. But what is interesting here, in many translations, I don't know about other languages, I speak now about English translations. This mediating activity was translated as mediated. And not only in the model, but in the text. In Russian language, we have two words. The first, apasreduyushaya deitelnost, which means the activity which mediates, mediating activity. And the other terminology is apasredovannaya, apasreduyushaya, apasredovannaya deitelnost, which is activity which is already mediating itself by something. Okay? Please, English speaking people.
Can you write it?
But is it?
But is
the difference in meaning between an action, something that's moving and something that's past?
Yeah, exactly. A mediated activity is mediated, already mediated.
It's done.
Mediated. It's in the past form, right? Mediated. It is already mediated. Yeah?
So mediating is...
And mediating activity, which mediates now.
Current.
Yeah.
Current, no.
Present continuous and present simple. Or past simple. Yeah. English grammar. Yeah? Because he speaks about mediating activity. Translators speak about mediated activity. Some people who are very fond of some triangles speak about mediated
activity.
No, no, thank you. I need the happiest triangle of this is how the business is, of course. And what is the difference between these two types of activities, mediated activity and mediated activity? Mediated activity is activity which is already formed, shaped, and developed as an activity. It is mediated, but mediating activity is an activity which describes the process, the transition from direct activity to mediated activity. Transition from one stage of development to the other stage of development. The transition from one qualitative stage to the other qualitative stage. It describes the process of transition, not the stages, as Piaget does. The process of this is the deep difference between mediated activity and mediating activity. And that's why I would like to draw your attention to this, because this is not only a language mistake, it's a deep methodological mistake, it's not a translation only, because it really misleads a lot of people who are still thinking that, well, mediated activity is the focus, but no. Mediated activity is already mediated. Everybody knows that every activity is mediated. Ah. Yeah? If I bring, it's already mediated because I use a bottle. If I eat, it's already mediated because I use a spoon. Ah, what an invention. But mediating activity, the activity in which I find the tool which might help me to conduct this activity, this is important. through creation, through search, transition from non-using tool to using tool. This is.
Nicola, can I interrupt you? Huh? Do we know if in Italian or in German or Spanish the translation is mediated